In the previous video, you learned how to create titles with the text tool, as well as some animation basics. In this video, we'll focus on changing the speed of segments in the sequence. You might call this speed changing or ramping. In Autodesk Smoke, this is called time warping. To follow along with the upcoming lessons, you can download the footage by clicking on the link displayed in the YouTube description. Or if you're using the podcast version of this video, you can type the link displayed in the internet browser to download the relevant files. In the sequence, we have a shot of a toy car driving across the screen and coming to a stop. Two ideas we'd like to try. Firstly, we want to slow the clip down for dramatic effect. And secondly, ramp the speed up and down for an obvious effect. Now, for the slow motion shot, I'll move 1 second into the clip. You can either drag the positioner or enter 1 second into the timecode indicator and press Add. Press Ctrl V to splice the segment. Select the segment and add an effect. In the Effects ribbon, I'll choose Time Warp. In the toolbar, you can see the effects pipeline and the basic parameters. So time warps are all about changing the playback speed of a clip. But it is also the place you go to reverse the playback of a clip. And that's worth remembering. There are 3 kinds of time warps in Smoke, and you can choose them from the pull-down menu. You have strobe, constant, and variable. Strobe repeats a frame a number of times to calculate its strobing effect. Constant uses the same value to affect the entire segment. And variable lets you modify the speed across the entire segment. We'll use constant for this example. The default speed is 100%. I'll change the speed to 25% to slow the segment down to a quarter of its initial speed. Playing the clip back, you can now see that the car is moving slowly. At this point, I want to draw your attention to the length of the segment. The segment's length in the sequence was not modified by the time warp. Because the shot is still 1 second long when it is played back, the car's movement ends earlier. This is not something to worry about because if you look at the frame handles at the end of the segment, you can see that the number of frames has been increased. So you could trim the segment to expose more frames by making the segment longer. So if you don't want the duration of the segment to physically change in the sequence, then this method is fine. However, if you want the segment to grow because of the time warp, then there is another option you need to switch. I'll undo the previous time warp by pressing Command Z to undo. Now zoom out of the sequence by holding Ctrl Option and dragging on the timeline view. To the far right of the sequence, you will find a button that controls keyframe animation behavior when manipulating a segment. In the context of time warping, Shift with Media will just time warp the segment with keyframes, but not affect the segment length. Now switch to Reposition Proportionately. This mode locks the first frame and last frame of the segment to the time warp's keyframes. Now go to the first frame of the segment and enter 25% into the speed slider. The segment now extends to 4 seconds in length and plays back at 25%. Note that the first frame and last frame are still the same. This is very useful if you have a source clip that is slightly shorter than the gap you are editing into. You can add a time warp to the segment and trim it out. As you trim the segment, this will adjust the segment's speed so that you can fill the gap. You will get used to these options and realize which one to use for a specific task. But one common issue with speed changing a segment is the stuttering effect because of the repeating frames. To deal with this, you have a couple options. The first option is known as frame mixing. This will mix past and future frames together, causing a trailing effect. The other option is motion estimation, or what other applications might call optical flow. Motion estimation does take longer to render, but instead of repeating frames, it morphs existing frames together to create new ones to fill in the gaps. Just in case you're wondering, the quarter resolution button is not about the final picture quality. It refers to the strictness of the motion estimation process. This default setting is optimal for most cases. As you can see, there is a really smooth dramatic effect being created by the slow-mo during playback. Now let's take the same shot and apply a variable time warp, or what some applications call speed ramping or time remapping. I'll switch the timeline effects to variable and go to the first frame. Let's start off with a speed of 100%. With the variable setting, auto key is on, and the yellow line tells us that there is a keyframe. Scrolling 12 frames into the segment, I'll set another keyframe of 200%. So between the first and the second keyframe, the speed will increase. Moving to 1 second into the segment, the car comes to a stop. I will right-click the speed field and set a keyframe with the current value. So the value between the second and the third keyframe is 200%. Now scrolling to the last half of the segment, you can see we have run out of frames. At 3/4 into the segment, I'll change the playback speed to -300% to play the media backwards. So playing the segment from the beginning, you can see how quickly you can keyframe the speed ramp effect. I'll set the mix value to 5. And press render to process the effect. If I play the clip back again, the car speeds into the frame, stops, and then reverses out of the picture. In the next video, we'll run through Autodesk Smoke's animation controls in detail.